brethren, I pray you sing a new song. Sing praise in the assembly of the righteous. Let the saints be joyful in glory. Let the high praise of God be on the mouths of the saints and a two-edged sword in their hands to execute vengeance on the demonic nations and punishments on those peoples, to bind their kings with chains. Dishonor have all his saints. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Sing to him a new song.
Like unto the Son of Man is Jesus Christ. Read on.
Oh. Clothed with a garment down to the foot.
So he clothed with a garment down to his foot. Read on.
And girded about the paps with a golden girdle.
He got a golden war belt on. Read on.
His head and his hands were white like wool.
No, his hair was like that. Jesus had woolly hair like this, according to the Bible. Read on.
As white as snow.
And it was as white as snow. Read on.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
And his eyes was as a flame of fire because Jesus of the Bible, this dark man with woolly hair, he had turned water into wine. That was his first miracle. And they called him a wine bibber. He loved to drink wine. The whites in his eyes turned red when he drank. Watch this. Read on.
And his feet like unto fine brass.
Is your feet the same color as the rest of your body? Right. So his feet is what?
Like unto fine brass.
What color is brass?
Brass.
What color is brass? You ever seen, you got a brass sculpture somewhere in your house, don't you?
You got a penny?
You got a penny?
I was about to say copper color.
Right. What is copper color? What color is it?
Reddish brown.
A brown, right? All right. Because a penny ain't red. Right. A penny is not the color of his.
No.
Right? If you pull out a penny, would it be like kind of like the color of my skin? And this is the polished version, right?
Okay.
So let's say the polished version. Read that report again.
And his feet like unto fine brass.
Fine brass.
As if they burned in a furnace.
So if you burn this in the furnace, what color will it come out?
Darker.
The Bible says that Jesus, the real Jesus of the Bible, is a dark-skinned man with woolly hair. So you see why we got the horns on that? Because that's a damn lie. That's a lie against God.
I've got a question. What is the purpose of his race? And I'm not saying you're wrong.
The purpose of his race is because it's in the Bible.
Right.
That's why. Let me get Hebrews chapter 7, verse 14. Because it's in the Bible. The Bible says, ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Right. So if it's in the Bible, it matters. Not because it matters to me, because it's in the Bible. Because if it's not the true depiction of who he is, that's a lie.
Right.
And the Bible don't.
You can't take the.
Hold on. I understand that. Right. So should they think that's? But it's not the true color of what he was. But it's not the truth. Doesn't that matter? Okay. Let me ask you a question. I'm gonna deal with you ladies. Let's say your father, right? He's a Caucasian man, right? No. In nationality, right?
Okay.
When you say your nationality, be Caucasian, right?
Yeah.
So let's say that your father was the mayor of Oklahoma. He did great things, right? And we live 20 years down the line, and I come about, and I say, hey, no, this is her father. It was a black man. I was there. You see what I'm saying? Would you like that?
Honestly, I don't give a shit about that kind of stuff.
Well,
no.
But you wouldn't like me if I lied and said your father was somebody he's not.
It's deceiving.
It's deceiving. The point.
I get it. I get it.
The point
is, a stupid comparison.
Right. I'm just giving.
I'm saying it's kind of like Santa Claus is not real, whereas Jesus is. I 100% think that. Whereas, I mean, there's a picture of Santa Claus, and he's mostly primarily white.
Right.
I mean, that could be wrong.
Well, everything is almost white, right?
The angels.
Everything is almost white.
Yeah.
That's the point. Let me ask y'all.
Not the Little Mermaid anymore.
Oh, now we go back to the Little Mermaid.
No,
hold on.
What about Moses?
What about Moses? What about when the so-called...
I'm okay with it.
Let me see.
What about Malibu's Most Wanted?
Yeah, what about Malibu's Most Wanted? What about... Go ahead.
Okay, so like regardless of what Jesus' skin color may be to you, to me, to anyone?
No, the Bible.
Right, okay, but regardless, why would you disrespect your God like
that's
that?
That's not him.
But nonetheless, what represents your God, what represents my God, look what you're putting on his face.
Hey, guess what?
Think about
that's
that.
The damn devil.
Think about
God. Guess what? You the damn devil that the Bible speaks of. You hate God. You hate God. You hate God.
hate God.
Right there.
You hate God. That's the point.
If you're
you hate what God created. You hate what God created.
Think about what God would have to say about that.
That's the point.
Think about what God would have to say about that.
God don't deal with you. Can you show me in the Bible what God did with you?
That doesn't make any sense.
Let me get. Hold on. Hold on.
Huh?
Now you sound like a damn fool. Now you sound like a fool. God was a woman?
Think about what?
What if the sky was red? And what?
Okay, great. I don't care about the color of anything.
There you
but
do.
Regardless.
See, that's how you go against God. God created beautiful colors, and you disown it. It don't matter about color, but God put colors everywhere.
Yes, and I love all the colors.
No, you don't. You don't love the true color of Hamashiach Yahusha.
Right, but not have a similar conversation?
Man, because she's talking about that I'm talking about God when she's talking about God and disrespecting God. What does blasphemy mean? What does blasphemy mean?
All I'm saying is, like, look at Jesus' name.
It's color in the Bible.
Okay, regardless
it's color in the
look
Bible.
Look at Jesus' name. Look at his name.
Let me get,
J-E-S-U-S is his name, and look what you're putting next to his name.
That is not Jesus. Can you show me Jesus in the Bible?
If that's his name,
listen,
you're putting it next to his name. And his name has nothing to
listen,
do with
listen,
skin color.
Listen, Little Mermaid reject. Listen, Little Mermaid reject. Hey, listen, how about this?
Now you're
I'm insulting you.
I am
insulting you.
I am a minor.
But go be in the world. Go ahead.
To have a conversation.
Read that.
Read that. You're yelling at me.
Read that.
And you don't need to do that.
Read that.
She wanted to hear your opinion.
I'm not going to give you my opinion.
But you're preaching your
I'm not going to preach my opinion.
You're not going to give me my opinion.
Let me get Proverbs chapter 3 verse
5. You're not going to give us your opinion. Look at yourself.
She wants to hear what you have to say.
Because he's yelling at me. No, because you're demeaning her. She has an opinion.
Well, hold on. She came in and insulted me, talking about.
She came
insulting me, said that I'm disrespecting Jesus. Well, you can't even find that in the Bible.
She came up.
I don't care about your damn God. I don't care about him. I care about the God of the Bible, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the God of the Israelites, the God of the so-called black, Hispanic, and Native Americans. I don't care about the goddamn white man's God. The white man God is the ones that did this to my people. The white man God is talking about going crazy, dropping bombs on other races. You want to talk about love? Shake your damn head. You believe in the damn devil.
Right, but I'm not even.
Wait, because you just said she believes.
Well, that's on you.
She believes
that's
in
on
love.
You.
She wants to hear what you have to say.
Read that up. The book of Proverbs, chapter 3, and verse 5. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not into thine own understanding.
Hey, lean not into your own understanding. Y'all can take your asses and pack it and go ahead down the road. All right? Now see your asses in captivity, okay?
That's right.
¿Estás hablando así?
What's,
no es la correcta forma. Mira, es tu gente. Este es tu gente, ¿sí o no? ¿A cómo?
No, pues sí.
¿A cómo? Dime. Ese es tu gente. Ok, ese es tu gente también. ¿Por qué estás hablando así?
Right.
No es correcto, señora.
You are a child of the Most High, and for you to be operating in that form, that lets me know that you have been blinded. That lets me know that you have been blinded. We have been coming out from the scriptures. You mad at the scriptures?
No, sir, I'm not
okay.
mad at the scriptures. I'm just mad
then
at
Then be
the...
mad at this then.
That's right,
then be
right.
mad at this.
No, yes, obviously.
And what, don't be mad at us because we didn't do that.
No, sir, I'm not mad at you.
Regardless,
I'm just mad
because the way we're talking to my sister.
I understand this. But what does the scripture say is who's our family? You want to find out who our family is? Bring it out in the book of Matthew. Who's our mother and who's our mother and our sister? Bring it out. The ones that are doing the law. You're going to tell me that your family didn't suffer? You're going to tell me that tu papá didn't go through none of this?
No, he didn't.
¿Cómo no? Yo soy Hispano. How come I can't tell you that? I can't tell you that.
That's
if they can't, I sure in the hell can.
Si, porque yo también.
¿Y tú qué?
Okay,
I'm going to tell you something.
No, yeah.
Why do you speak Spanish?
Because you believe in the Bible?
Yes.
And it's a way.
I'm going to show you that the reason why this guy got horns on his head.
Okay.
And it makes the other nations mad.
Okay.
Okay. Then why can't you see the other end? If you can see this end here, then why can't you see the other end of instruction? I understand this. Guess what? Do you not know that I have 2 degrees? But yet when you get me on the phone, I sound white.
No, yeah. So do I have that too? All right, give me that one.
I have 2 degrees.
Revelation.
Why am I still today? No damn job. Answer me that question. If you're such a smart person, and you want to talk about the price.
I'm going to ask you that question.
His head and his hairs were white like wool.
His head and his hairs were white like wool. He had woolly hair.
And you know what
the Bible says. Watch this.
As white as snow.
And his hair was white as snow. Read on.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
And his eyes was a flame of fire. Read on. Not blue eyes, not green eyes. His eyes was red. Read on.
And his feet. Like that you find red.
Look at that sister's feet, y'all.
Right, and they use that image to put Shah forefathers in this captivity to make them, well, not even, that's misnomer, because where's the Middle West, where's the Middle South, where's the Middle South, if we got a Middle East, we got to have a Middle West, right, in the Middle South, okay, you know what I'm saying, so they naming that to keep people confused.
Okay.
You see what I'm saying? So what you would be talking about, Palestine, Israel, Mediterranean, and that nature, that area, right? But according to the Bible, like she's saying, he was a dark man. He came from a melanated region. See what I'm saying? But they used this image to put our people into captivity.
Right. In a region where they had color.
Right. And he was born in a region where he had color, because even when he was born, when Herod was trying to kill him, him and Mary fled into Africa.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? How can they fled into Africa and they never found him, but who they called Jesus lived to be 33 years old. You see what I'm saying? So they never found him. Why did they never found him? Because he blended in with the people. If he was a white baby, they were like, oh, yep, there go that white baby Jesus right there. Y'all go get him. You see what I'm saying?
He was not that color.
That right there is a lie, and that's against the Bible, and that's against God, and that's the devil right there.
Right.
That was the devil that's been pushed in everybody's mind to keep everybody docile. So this brother right here won't look like he's above everybody. Yeah, I want you to think that. You ever felt like you're special, my brother? You know why you thought you were special, but you feel never put. Did you ever find out what you were special about, though? What was special about you? What?
Just who I am.
Who are you?
Trey.
But who are you, though?
Son of God.
Son of God. Who are the sons of God in the Bible?
The Israelites,
my brother.
Yeah, they're children of God.
That's right. And you are children of God, and they took your heritage. They took your heritage, my brother, and put you down at the bottom. Let me get that in Deuteronomy real quick.
God, is Deuteronomy?
Okay, you got 7-6? Okay, give me 7-6 real quick. Let me get 36.
Deuteronomy 7-6. But thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God.
So God said that you are holy people unto the Lord thy God. You see, the other nations, they're going to treat you holy. They ain't treat you holy. They ain't treat your grandma holy, your uncle holy. And even in the 60s, when they had the civil rights area, they ain't treat none of us holy. They treated us like dogs. Look at this, man.
Right.
And they're talking about we
and
people.
That's wrong, right?
And that's wrong, right? Read on.
The Lord thy God has chosen thee to be a special people unto himself.
So they didn't tell you that the Most High God said that we were special people.
Right.
And to him.
Right.
Read on.
Above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
What did he say?
Above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
Now we equal.
Above all people
that are upon the face of the earth.
So my brother, you special. That's why you special. Because you above these other nations. Man.
Now what's this right here that says the 12 tribes of Israel?
So the 12 tribes of Israel. You got 12 tribes, right?
Right.
So scoop the post over, brother.
Because I see. So how do I know which tribe I'm from?
How do you know which tribe you're from? Because of, right, of the prophecies of the Bible.
Right.
Okay?
So Judah is Negro.
Judah is a so-called Negro.
So-called.
Right?
So-called.
Right, so if you come from the so-called transatlantic slave trade, right, you would be considered as a Judite, so, Benjamite. Go ahead.
I'm sorry. So the Negroes from Judah came from the slave ship in what? 1619 So 1619 is when it started. So they came from Judah. So they took slaves from Judah and brought them to America.
Well, they came from the west coast.
From the west coast of Africa.
Is that where Judah is located?
Yeah, the land of Judah is actually in the west. The kingdom of Judah is in the west coast of Africa. You can find it on maps, right? So we occupied that land, but that's not originally our land.
Right.
We invaded on that land running from the Romans when they ransacked Jerusalem.
Right.
So we fled out of Israel and ran into Africa running from them.
Okay.
See what I'm saying? And then we occupied and inhabited the west coast of Africa for a certain period of time before they came and sold us into captivity.
Now what about the Benjamin?
Well, Benjamin is the West Indies. They down there in the Caribbean.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? They were sold into captivity too.
Now, what about Mexico?
The Mexicans, they were sold into captivity too.
Issachar. Where is that located?
Issachar would be the so-called Hispanics.
Where is that located in the Bible map?
Let me get that. All these tribes was in Israel,
yeah.
So it had a certain like you got Edmond, right? Hold on, let me ask you this. Edmond, you got Edmond, Bethany, Dale City, right? So you got Edmond would have been the Judah. That's where the Judites was. You got Bethany would have been where the Issachar was.
Right.
So they had a region where they was located.
So did. The Europeans moved the Mexicans?
Yes, you got the...
They brought the Mexicans over here?
No, they came here on their own.
Right. Mexicans.
But then when the Spanish conquistadors came to this side of the world, with their Spanish armadas, right, Francisco Pizarro, Cortez, De Soto,
right,
they basically came over here to this side of the world to start selling them back to England, right, and Portugal and Spain and like that.
And too, they brought Negroes from West Africa and sold them all throughout the Caribbean through Mexico.
Right.
So you see us dark.
And then yeah, I
look straight like Mexicans.
This is the apocrypha. This is the book
that
they took out. Yeah, this is what they took out of the Bible.
That out of the Protestant church.
So you guys read it from the New Testament?
Oh,
whole book.
Holy Bible.
So let me ask you this one. You guys believe in the New Testament?
Yes. That's why we're showing you the truth about Jesus Christ.
Right, and I see this.
Yeah.
Okay. So white, Jesus is the devil.
That's the devil, man. The white people in general are the damn devils. Look at
him.
If you had to pick a people on the earth, who would you say be?
So, what are the white people in the Bible then? Are they part of the 12 tribes, or what are they a part of?
Huh?
Because I don't see their names on here.
Huh? Because they're not on here. They're not one of the 12 tribes. They're not guys who talk to people.
Right.
Let's get this to 25:25.
Look, because think about it.
Yeah.
The Jewish people.
Okay.
Today, do they include everybody else?
Are they not on here?
No, I'm saying the Jewish people. Like, we know how they get down. Do they include everybody else?
They talking about, like, the Holocaust Jews?
Yeah. Do they include everybody else? Can you go up in their synagogue and be like, hey, Jewish.
No, you can't do that.
So, but they say that they're the children of the book. They don't include everybody else. So now when we do it, everybody got a problem with it.
Now, look at this, man. Look at this. Look at this brother right here. Is he white or is he red?
I don't know, he got some type of, he like got some, I don't know.
Look at his neck. Is he white or is he red?
He got a tan on the back of that
neck. Hold on, a tan? That's a tan. He's not tan. See what I'm saying?
Say that.
Go ahead. Don, this is Genesis 25 and 25. Now look at his sister right here. Look.
Okay.
Red.
Okay.
Watch this. It says, and the first came out red all over like a hairy garment. The first one came out red all over like a hairy garment. They red and they hairy. And they called his name Esau.
You
you won't find the white man in the Bible. They don't say white man, this is the white man. They don't say this is the black man in the Bible.
So what are they called in the Bible?
Esau. He's just ready. Read it again.
Done. And the first came out red all over like a hairy garment. Okay. And they called his name Esau. And after that, his brother came out.
So after that, his brother came out. Uh-huh.
And his hand took hold on Esau's heel.
His hand took hold on Esau's heel. Why didn't I describe his brother? Because his brother looked like all the rest of the people. This was something new on the world. A red baby came out.
So that's not his brother?
Let's go back to verse 23. Read that.
God, verse 23. And the Lord said unto her, two nations are in thy womb.
Two nations.
I know.
In her womb.
Two nations,
So
who are those two nations?
Judah and Israel.
Huh?
Judah and Israel? No, it was Judah and Esau. I mean, so like it's Jacob and Esau.
Jacob and Esau.
So who do they represent as
the nations? Jacob is the so-called black, Hispanic, and Native American. And then you have all the people that come on this side. These are Jacob.
So Esau represents what? Edomites?
The Edomites. You got the so-called white people. Okay, you got the Romans. So you got the...
It's coming together.
You got the Italians. You got all them are Edomites.
Now, what does Deuteronomy 23:7 say?
Right, now go to Deuteronomy 23:7.
Read that.
Somebody open the phone real quick.
Right.
Oh,
yeah. Because I ran across that passage. And I need some clarity on that.
I got it. Matter of fact, no, just go to
Deuteronomy 23:7.
Yeah, I got you.
Clarity on that.
This is Deuteronomy chapter 23, verse 7. Thou shalt not abhor an Edomite, for he is thy brother. Uh-oh. Thou shalt not abhor an Egyptian, because thou wast a stranger in his land.
Right, so where
are
you going with that?
I just want to know, I need some clarity.
Okay.
Abhor means to hate. So okay. He said we shall not hate.
Watch this, I'm going to show you. You got that real quick? Stones?
Abhor. Abhor means the way. Not hate?
Hold on, no. I need Blue Letter. Come on.
I got Blue Letter Bible on my phone.
Go there, that's all praise. Go to Blue Letter real quick. I'm about to show you. All praise. I'm about to show you right now that word right there that they got inserted as Edomites ain't even what it is. When you do, the Bible says study to show thyself approved, right? So we got to study it. We got to see. Why would the Most High tell us not to hate Esau, but then go to Deuteronomy 25 verse 40 real quick.
And he'll be exterminated off the face of the earth.
Edomite. It says descendants of. It says descendants of Edom, the nation of. That's King James too.
All right, now hold on. Let me show you something real quick. You see how it says Syria right there? All right, now.
It says one time that's mentioned.
Hold on, watch this. I'm about to show you something real quick. It's going to tell us that it's a clerical error.
Syria.
Let's go to. I think it's C726. Press C726. A clerical error, right here. It's a clerical error.
The etymology is a clerical
error. Etymology of. Right, so that word that they put right there.
Or what word? Oh,
Syria.
Huh?
Edomite,
right there.
Right.
It's a clerical error.
So that means an error in this book then?
Well, yes, it's an error because man translated in the English.
So why we read
that? No, listen. Because you can't read Hebrew, can you?
No,
so that's why, hold on, listen to me, my brother. The Most High says study to show thyself approved.
Right.
If it was just so easy to go in the book and say this is what it is,
right,
we wouldn't have to study it.
Right.
You see what I'm saying?
Right.
Because it was translated by man. Is man perfect? Can man make mistakes? Thank you.
That's why.
So we don't just throw the book away because it has a simple error in there. We study and see and build upon that and see exactly what the Bible is saying. But it said it's a clerical error because it's talking about Syrians.
Right.
Okay? Now watch this. Hold on, where my Bible is? What's your name for Syrian?
Hey. That's crazy. class time.
There we go, right there. So look, now let me show you something real quick. Alright, let me get
You need that clerical error?
I got it right here. Give me the scripture where it gives me Esau's genealogy. I think it's like
First Chronicles.
No. It's in what about Genesis, Jesus? Like 32.
What about Jesus' genealogy? What about Jesus' genealogy in
Matthew?
Let me show you this real quick.
Go there.
No. Stay right there.
Then we can make.
I need Genesis 36 real quick to show Esau's genealogy real quick, so I can prove a point.
Genesis 36. Now these are the generations of Esau.
All right, so read verse 1. Girl, let me prove a point, my brother. I got you.
Genesis chapter 36, verse 1. Now these are the generations of Esau, who is Edom.
So who is Edom?
Esau took his wives of the daughters of Canaan.
Right.
Adah, the daughter of Elon,
right,
the Hittite.
So now jump up to verse 11. Watch this.
Verse 11. And the sons of Eliphaz were Teman.
So it's given the genealogy, my brother. Listen.
Teman, Omar, Zepho, and Gatam.
Read on.
And Kenaz.
Read on.
And Teman was concubine to Eliphaz.
Read on.
Esau's son.
Esau's son. Read on.
And she bare to Eliphaz Amalek.
And she bare to Eliphaz Amalek. So Amalek come from Esau, right? We just read it.
These were the sons of Adah, Esau's wife.
Right. So these are the sons of Adah, Esau's wife. Okay? Now watch what he says. And right after he says, thou shalt not abhor Edomite, he says this. Watch this.
John, this is Deuteronomy 25 and 19. Therefore it shall be, when the Lord thy God hath given thee rest from all thine enemies round about, in the land which the Lord thy God hath given thee for an inheritance.
If he says, he said, blot out from Amalek from under heaven, what does that mean?
I don't know, Joe.
You destroy him. You blot him out. If I blot something out on the paper, I destroyed it. You see what I'm saying? He said, blot out the Amalekites from under heaven. So the Amalekites are Esau. So now one verse he's saying, two chapters before, don't hate the Edomites. Is it really saying don't hate the Edomites? Or then a couple chapters later, he's saying, you should blot them out from under heaven. Now, I'm going to show you, according to the Bible, the Most High God hates the Edomites, too. I'm going to show you that. Watch this. Let me get some.
Ask you this. So, anybody that's not an Israelite, the Lord hates.
I can't say that anybody that's not an Israelite that he hates, but he hates the Edomites because it's in the Bible.
Right.
God hates the white man in the Bible.
You don't know what God hates.
Let me get Romans chapter 9, verse 13.
Yeah, we got to go.
All right.
And then I got just one question.
You wanted the genealogy of
Let me just get the genealogy of Jesus.
In
Matthew 1, and then because
16? You wanna go into the virgin birth?
No.
Verse 16.
Yeah, starting in verse 5. With Ruth being a part of the genealogy, now she wasn't fully Jew, was she?
That's up for debate. It's up for debate.
If it's up for debate, that means Jesus wasn't really fully.
Because you still from your seed come from your father.
That's right. And Joseph was the one.
But that's
16.
In the genealogy, though.
Right. Just because a woman is in the genealogy, let's go to the Torah real quick and show this brother. Numbers 1 and 18.
So the genealogy doesn't have anything to do with genes.
Yeah, it does. It comes from your father. You see all men that's mentioned in that.
But it starts here, but this generation, it says it starts from the son of David.
Right, that's a man.
Abraham.
That's a man.
And it keeps continuing.
So where the woman, how was David from the lineage without the mother being mentioned in that verse?
Right. Why is Ruth mentioned?
That's because, read the verse about Ruth. Read it.
No, it just says, and Salam began Booz at Rechad, and Booz begat Obed and Ruth.
Right. So that brother begot Ruth.
It says Booz begot Obed of Ruth.
Right. It says he begot Obed of Ruth.
Obed.
Obed. That's the subject matter right there.
It's
that old man begot Jesse.
So that's up for debate as far as if she was the one.
Right, because it's really not too much.
She was a Moabite.
Huh?
She was a Moabite.
It says a Moabite tent.
She dwelt in the land, boy.
Right. Just like she was a citizen of Moab.
Right.
Just like you said, Paul was a Roman.
Just like you call yourself an American. You see what I'm saying? But you're not American.
Woman.
Right.
Of the ancestors of King David. One of the ancestors of King David.
Well,
that's what the blue letter says.
I know. I understand. Everything that's in there is not. It's speculation. You see what I'm saying? We got to get real deep into it and see and keep studying. But it's what.
One more question. What about Job? Was he an Edomite?
No. Job was from Israel. It
says he was in the land of Uz.
Right. He was an Israelite.
Flickering American.
Let me get that.
Land of
America.
Remember. Motherfucker, remember? Motherfucker never loved us.